Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is ng News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. SignalForms have been merged into the main branch. And since Wednesday, there's even a release of Angular tagged with next, not latest, that includes the new SignalForms. That means for very enthusiastic developers, you can give it a try. But be aware, this is a pre-experimental status. That means it's not perfect, bugs will be fixed, things might change very quickly, and documentation also will be added. But if you really want to live on the bleeding edge, give it a try. Last week, there was also the Angular Q&A session with Mark Thompson and Jeremy Elborn from the Angular team. Obviously, SignalForms were a topic. There was a question if SignalForms are going to replace reactive forms, and the answer is
yes. Over the long run, SignalForms becomes like the way of doing forms in Angular. We don't have any concrete plans about like deprecating or deleting the original form systems because so many applications would be depending on them.
The majority of the session was about zoneless. When asked about the consequences for our architecture,
the biggest architecture change is that you need to be more explicit about your state tracking. And do that in such a way that the framework can know when something may have changed instead of it being automatic based on zones. And so you do have to be a little bit more mindful about state.
In fairness to zones, one of the things that it provided for us was just the fact that you didn't have to think about a lot of these things. What value proposition at the time made a ton of sense.
Jeremy also gave an update on the broader vision of modern Angular. At the very end, Mark announced another live stream which is scheduled for September the 16th. It's called Explore the World of Possibilities and will focus on Angular and AI. Disclaimer, there is a rule that ngNews cannot be used for self-promotion, but sometimes there are exceptions, especially if a whole team is involved. The ngrx toolkit is a library which supports a set of different features for the ngrx signal store. The most popular feature is probably support for the Redux DevTools. Now, by the initiative of Manfred Steyer, who is like me a member of the ngrx toolkit team, we've introduced a mutation feature that can even be used outside the signal store. Mutations is the term the Angular team often uses to describe the opposite of resources, namely when we want to update state on the server. Right now, the Angular team does not prioritize mutations because they are fully focused on the signal forms. But for some of us who want to go all in on signals, mutations are essential. And now we have the possibility to use them. With mutations, you can define a post, put, or delete HTTP command, which can then be invoked. The ngrx toolkit version handles race conditions and exposes status information, both per mutation and globally. The exposed metadata is quite similar that we find already in the resource. So if you're looking to adopt a mutation mindset, then this is one way forward. Be aware that there might be an official mutation solution, but not that soon. And to be fair, this is not the first implementation of mutations. There have been others. First and foremost, Angular Query. Then the CRUD resource by Thomas Trajan, and GraphQL clients with built-in mutation support, and of course others. It's very often said that updating Angular is quite straightforward. You just execute ng-update and that's it. But one of the main challenges are the third-party libraries, which might lag behind or might not even be maintained anymore. This exact topic, the hidden costs of updating Angular, was the focus of last week's Angular Space podcast with host Armin Fadanyan and guest Gerome Grignon. Analog.js, a meta framework for Angular, dropped its support for the ng format. A little bit of a context. The ng format was a different authoring format, which purely focused on the template and didn't use classes. When it was introduced, it caused quite a disturbance in the Angular community. Later on, the Angular team mentioned that they are internally experimenting with similar formats, and it could be very well that one of these formats eventually makes it out of those internal experiments. Finally, the Angular team published a summary of all the features they did during the summer. It's a great overview if you want to catch up on everything that happened in recent months. And that's it. I wish you a nice week and see you in the next episode. Goodbye.